Welcome to The Snapshot, a series examining the forces shaping and driving global commodity markets today. Our focus is the US ethanol industry, which faces several challenges in 2016, including low prices, poor production margins, and high stocks. Ethanol's value as a blending component is largely linked to the price of gasoline. However, since ethanol is produced from corn, compared with gasoline's feedstock of crude oil, biofuel has different production economics. The average price of gasoline in January in the Midwest fell over 22% compared with the previous month. Ethanol, meanwhile, reached a 10-year low at the beginning of January and had a month-on-month fall of 7%. The resulting premium of ethanol to gasoline makes blending ethanol into domestic fuel supplies to meet federal mandates a costly endeavor and discourages any non-mandated renewable fuel blending. Ethanol rose to a roughly 87% gallon premium to gasoline February 8th, a higher premium than at any point in 2015, when ethanol averaged about an 11 cent discount. At the same time, corn, the main feedstock for US ethanol production, has not echoed the falls seen across oil. The front month seaborne corn futures price fell just 2% in January 2016 when compared with December 2015. The comparatively higher corn prices have eroded ethanol production margins. As a result, some facilities have shut down and production has been trimmed across the eastern US corn belt, as well as destination plants, due to the high regional cost of corn. One bright note is that ethanol co-products such as dried distillers grain and animal feed are supporting production margins due to the cold weather and some export demand. The smaller drop in corn values has also put a floor to ethanol prices, contributing to the large difference between gasoline and ethanol price trends in the US. Falling production margins were a common theme in several recent earnings calls, with companies such as Valero and ADM reporting dramatic year-on-year falls in the fourth quarter of 2015 earnings. A recent presentation at the National Ethanol Conference by Ocean Park Advisors and Christensen and Associates highlighted the expectation of an increase in mergers and acquisitions throughout the industry in response to the challenging operating environment. Weekly ethanol production data, meanwhile, crossed the 1 million barrel a day level three times during the last year, resulting in ethanol stocks building. US energy information data from the week ended February 12th showed ethanol stocks at an all-time high of 23.218 million barrels. So even with production volumes having come off their highs, clearly there is still plenty of ethanol around. With not enough US demand to absorb all this volume, particularly over the low demand winter period, sources say market participants are looking more and more to export markets to absorb this length. Until next time on The Snapshot, we'll be keeping an eye on the markets.